Hi, welcome back. In this video lesson, we will learn about a very important concept called class. It's really important, but at the same time pretty simple. So we're going to talk about class using two examples. First, we will cover the theory, and then we will get into some practical examples. So let's begin. As you see on the screen, we have the following text. For heading 1, we got lorem ipsum, and then we got two paragraphs with the lorem ipsum text in them. By the way, this lorem ipsum is called a dummy text. It is often used by front-end developers when they still don't have the final text, and that is why they use a dummy text to work with. You can get this dummy text on the libsyn.com website. And here is the text that's used right here. Good. Okay, as I mentioned, we got one heading and two paragraphs. Suppose we want to make H1 blue. So we want to make this lorem ipsum thing blue. For that in CSS, we would write for H1 color blue. Now as you can see, the heading is blue. And what if we want to make the heading in all caps? Easy. To do this, we just add a property called textTransform. As you may recall, we actually covered this property in a previous video. So we set the value for it as uppercase. And now you see that all of the letters are indeed in uppercase. And if you want all of the paragraphs to be orange, then in CSS for the P selector, we're going to give it a color property and set it as orange. And as a result, now our paragraphs have orange text. What if we also want to make all the paragraphs in italic? Again, no problem. We just add a property called fontStyle with the value italic. And that's it. Now our two paragraphs are using italics. But what if we want the first paragraph to be of a different color? We don't want to apply it to all of the paragraphs. For that reason, we use a thing called a class. Class is a special attribute that gives a tag a special name. And that allows us to refer to that tag specifically. We're going to add the word class in the p tag, and then let's give this class the name special, for example. Please note that we use the name special, but you can use any name you want. Next, in CSS, we're going to refer to this class. To do that, we write dot and then the name of the class, that is, the word special, in our case. Then, in the curly brackets, we're going to add the property of this class. We're going to write color black, for example. And now, as you can see, specifically our first paragraph changed its color from orange to black. Please notice how I wrote the class name in CSS. First it was a dot, then the class name, then a pair of curly brackets, and then we added the styles. So basically, whenever you see a dot and a word, then you should know it's a class. Alright, but what if we wanted the first paragraph to have a thick lettering, to be in bold, for example? Then we need to add another property, fontWeightBold. And this is also something we learned in the previous video. As a result, we've got the first paragraph not only black, but now it's also in bold. Okay, let's move on to another example. Suppose we have two lists. As you see, the first one is an unordered list and the second one is an ordered list. As you already know, to get an unordered list in HTML, first we need to wrap the text in a UL tag. And then, each element has to be wrapped in an li tag. And to get an ordered list, we need to use an ol tag instead of the ul tag. But then it's the same thing. We just use the li tags for each list item. But how do we make it so that, for example, the first element of the unordered list is orange, while all the other ones stay green? Well, for that we need to use a class. We're just going to write class and then the name of the class. Let's call it, for example, change. Then, in CSS, we refer to the class by writing .change. And then, in the curly brackets, we need to add color orange. And now, as you see, our first element is in orange. Next, let's add another property. For example, font weight bold. And now the first element is not only in orange, but also in bold. Let's say we want the second element of the unordered list to also be orange and bold. Well, we don't have to write another class, we can simply use the same class a second time. Let's add that class here. Now it's also in orange and in bold. But say we want the first element of the ordered list to be both bold and orange. Well, it's the same thing. We just need to add class with the name change. And then, as a result, it's both orange and bold. Alright, so that part is clear. Now, let's move on to the practice part. So let's open both our HTML and CSS, and then we're going to create an H1 in HTML. And here we write lorem ipsum. Then, after that, we're going to create two p tags. Let's use some dummy text inside. And for that, we're just going to the website that we mentioned before. We're going to copy this paragraph right here, and then paste it in our p tag. Do the same thing for the other one. As a result, if we save this right now and refresh the page, this is what we get. Alright, so say we want the heading, the H1, to be in blue. How do we do that? Well, for that we're going to write H1 in CSS, referring to H1, and then just color and blue. Save that and refresh the browser. And now it's in blue. Suppose we want the paragraphs to be in orange. For that, we're referring to the p tag, so we're going to have a p selector and then just write color orange. And as you can see, now both of our paragraphs are in orange. But what if we specifically want the first paragraph to be in green? Well, because we wrote the p selector, it doesn't really differentiate between the two paragraphs. So if we add some styles for the p tag, they will be applied to all the paragraphs, to both of them. So what if we want to add some unique styles to the first paragraph? It's very easy. We simply need to add another class to this paragraph. For the class name, you can basically write anything that you want, but it's better to have a self-explanatory name so that it's less confusing. So what we could do here is, we could write the name of the color we want this paragraph to change to. So say, if we want to change to green, then we can just write green text right here. Then, we're going to refer to this class in CSS. So to do that, we just write dot and then the name of the class. And then we just write color green. Save and refresh. And as you see, specifically the first paragraph is now in green. Say we want the first paragraph to also be in bold. What do we do then? Well, there are two options. First of all, we can just add another property down here. So it's going to be color green, and then we would have font weight bold. And that's definitely going to work. Save this and refresh the page. And we see that it's now both in green and in bold. However, there is a problem with that because the class name that we wrote is green text. We didn't mention anything about the thickness of the letters here, so that's a little bit confusing. That's why there is another option, and we can actually add another class. So in CSS, we're going to use another class. Let's call it, for example, something like bold text, which would make sense. Then we just add the property in the curly brackets that we need. So it's going to be font weight bold. And now, how do we connect this style to the first paragraph? Well, it's really simple. If you want to have multiple classes in an element, all you have to do is add multiple classes and then you just separate them with a space. So here we have green text, and then we just add the other name of the class, which is bold text. By the way, the order of these classes, it doesn't really matter. And as a result, if we save this now and refresh, the first paragraph is going to get the styles from both of the classes. As you see, it works great. So even though this is a simple concept to understand, it's a really important one. Great, that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next one.